Campaign Week. Today we're going to talk about Cadbury. So as I said, Cadbury is a confectionery brand recognized and treasured around the world. But curiously enough, they had humble beginnings. The story commenced in 1824, as my research shows, when John Cadbury opened a grocery shop in Ball Street, Birmingham. Because Quakers at the time believed that alcohol was bad for the society, John focused on selling tea, coffee, cocoa, and drinking chocolate, which were considered as being healthy at the time. Inspired not only by his taste, but by his belief as well, that the company grew and became one of the world's most popular chocolate brands. When looking at leading brand sales in the chocolate and confectionery market by value and volume in 2015 and 2016, according to the same Mintel report, Dairy Milk, which is owned by Mondelez, is the leading brand with 501 million in 2015 and 497 million in 2016, followed by Galaxy and Maltesers, which are owned by Mars, and then Twirl, which is owned by Mondelez again, and then Kit Kat, which is owned by Nestle, and then M&M's, which is owned again by Mars.
Carola, I'm Alan, your presenter, and we're going to have today as guest Katie Nichols, the head of marketing department of Cadbury's. Katie, it's nice to have you here.
Hi Anna, it's nice to be here.
So, what do you think would be the strengths of Cadbury's?
Well, first of all, I think one of our big strengths really is the fact that we have a really high market share of 25%. That's a lot larger than our competitors, and we are number one. Also, we have a very strong brand image, as you can tell. Cadbury's, everybody associates it with purple, and a lot of people love the brand.
Okay, but throughout the years, you had quite a bad publicity with bad appearances in like newspapers. For example, they did find wasps and a moth inside your Dairy Milk bar. What do you have to say about it? Also, before you answer, there's also been accuses of racism ads in your adverts. What do you have to say about it?
Yes, it's true. Over the years, we have had some bad appearances on the news. However, a lot of companies go through this. I'm not saying that we're anything special. And we did think it was unacceptable. Therefore, we held an investigation and sorted out the matter straight away. And we also still have a very strong customer loyalty even after that happened, as customers know that mistakes do happen. Furthermore, for the racism acts, yes, we apologise immediately for anyone who felt concerned about that, and we've done our best to sort it out. We straight away ended the commercial and ended the campaign and apologised to Naomi personally and anyone, once again, who feels affected. We apologise for that. It was meant to be funny and not racist.
Okay, everyone appreciate that. So, your industry and, of course, your company is going through some threats of the industry right now. For example, the increase of raw material is one. And the other one is the fact that there's many people that are concerned about the sugar content of your products. What do you have to say about this?
Well, in terms of sugar content concern, yes, everyone is getting concerned about healthiness and stuff like that. That's why we decided to bring out new healthier chocolate bars that are more biscuit orientated and we're trying to make it healthier. And in terms of the increase of price raw material, that's something that not only affects us, but it also affects the whole of the chocolate confectionery. So it's a problem, but we can't do anything about it.
And what about Brexit?
Well, Brexit does affect us in the UK. However, as we're an international business, we don't think it will affect us that much.
I'm sure it won't. So, how do you see your company developing in the future? What do you think are your opportunities?
We're thinking of entering entering rural markets. We were thinking of India because that's a very rural market, and we found through research that Indians are really into chocolate and sweets, and so we're working on that, trying to increase our business. We would also like to increase our market share in order to be even more successful against our competitors.
That's great. Thank you, Katie. Thank you very much.
You are number 7 in the queue.
With Cadbury's, and we've got here Katie
and my lovely head of department Christina,
and we're going to discuss about the Moments of Joy campaign, which was one of the most successful campaigns of Cadbury's. So Katie, when that campaign took place?
So the campaign was for the London Olympic Games in 2012.
And Christina, how long did this campaign run for?
The campaign ran for from August 2010 until July 2012.
And Katie, where?
So the campaign took place in England, but with a focus on London as the games were in London.
And Christina, tell us, what was the budget?
We had a budget of £50 million.
Okay, so I think it's important to discuss your objectives for the campaign. So Katie, do you want to tell me something about it?
Yeah, we, as you said, thought that it was very important, so we put through some SMART objectives. To begin with, our specific goal was for the sponsorship to pay for itself overall. And then secondly, we wanted to increase our market share by 1% throughout the campaign.
Sounds terrific. And Christina, how did you think that your objectives were measurable? How did you manage?
We wanted to increase our social media followers, or also the market share and our sales, obviously.
Okay, and what about Katie? How did you think that they were achievable?
I think they were achievable as we're, it was a long-term, I'm forgetting my words, sorry. It was a long-term campaign. So yeah, the budget was expensive, but at least it was long-term, so it spread out a bit. And we're also a very strong and steady business.
That's great. And what about the, did you think that your objectives were realistic?
We think so. They were pretty realistic. We had a very high budget. Also, we conducted good material and we had a long time skip.
That's great. So now, to you, Christina, we're going to discuss about our your campaign and your media choice and how you manage this. And of course, you are like the head of like your media department. So, what channels did you use to maximize the results of your campaign?
Well, Cadbury came with a truly integrated multimedia campaign that ran on TV, radio, social media, press, in-store and billboard.
Okay, and how did you manage such a great achievement?
Well, this huge growth came from complex planning, but a very simple promotional message.
Sounds great. And what was exactly the purpose of this campaign?
Well, as you know, during the Olympics, Cadbury also had a large presence on radio. So we asked people to tweet about their favorite players in the key moments, and then we broadcasted their message on TV. So I believe that the purpose of this campaign was to for the whole nation to get behind an athlete in a historical moment.
Okay, I know that you also had like a huge online and offline activity in Ireland. Do you want to tell me something about it?
Yes, we became, luckily, we became the official sponsor of RTE, which is like the BBC of Ireland. And we had an online and offline coverage of London 2012 Olympics.
this media plan sounds amazing. Do you want to tell me the results of the campaign in terms of media traffic?
Yes, the results were our Dairy Milk Cadbury ran through every break during the Olympics, and we reached to 850 ad breaks.
Wow, that's amazing. Thank you very much, Christina. So we're here with Katie and Christina, and we're going to discuss the results of this outstanding campaign. So, Katie.
Well, yes, Anna, it was truly unbelievable. We had the highest value sale peak in 2 years. Our value brand share grew by 4%. Our business sales grew by 66% in a year. And the value of our units grew by 60% in just a year.
Also, our single pack sales increased by 17%, the multiple pack by 12%, and we managed to sell bags by 90%.
Okay, Christina, remaining with you, can you tell me something about the precise results of your media campaign?
Yes, Cadbury's Olympic sponsorship resulted in 25,000 followers, more than plus 25,000 followers on Twitter, 35,000 followers on Facebook, and more than 200,000 followers on Google+. Also, Cadbury's is the first brand to use a promoted trend in relation to the Olympic Games 2012.
These results are sure outstanding.
We're very proud of them.
So here we had the first advert, the Sports Vessel Stripes race season advert from the Moments of Joy Cadbury's campaign.
In the lead up to London 2012, Cadbury Sports V Stripes presents a season of races. Your life is about to get a little bit faster. Speed typing. Lurol unraveling. And now, bed making. Mouse scrolling. 100 meters, that is. Tea making. Doodling. With 9 world records to break, find out how fast you are at sportsvstripes.com.
And this was the second advert, the Let the Goo Games Begin advert, which was part of other 5 adverts similar to this.
Goo 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 goo.
So now you've seen the adverts, and we're going to have a discussion with Katie, as we know in marketing department, that she's going to go more in depth about the rationale behind them. So Katie, do you want to start talking about the first one, the race season advert?
So the race season advert meant, as you've just seen, it was real people. The image was competition themed, as it's the Olympics, so we thought that would be a good idea. We used British imagery, so as you can see, there's people racing for tea and stuff like that, so we made it very relatable for our target audience.
Of course.
And of course, as per usual, we used the lovely purple Cadbury's colours.
I could see that. I also noticed that there was quite a fast-paced music and humoristic music that gave this competition sense to it. Don't you agree?
Yes, of course we agree. As mentioned about the imagery, it's the same for the sound. We try to make it more competition, fast-paced movement that goes with the competition type of thing. And as every sports activity, there's a sports commentator to get you really in the mood of the Olympic Games.
Yeah, I could feel that. So we could say that there was like kind of like a humoristic appeal to this, right? But it's not the only advert that has this humoristic appeal, is it?
No, we thought that humor is a way to remember adverts, in our opinions. And so we used that for our final countdown advert, which is also an Olympics advert, and Let the Goo Games Begin. however, Let the Goo Games Begin was a little different, as we used animations, and that was like more focused on the April time, as it's Easter and people associate it with cream eggs.
Of course. Can I just say, between me and you, that it was absolutely my favourite outfit. It was very good, the animation, I really liked it. The theme of competition is pretty clear, as well as the theme of Easter, as you said. And I could see that we could hear again like cheering sounds of sport commentator, but there was this like comic sounds of like the new like language of like the cream eggs that was absolutely very funny.
We wanted to make it a little different to other ones. We didn't want them all to be the same, so they're all competition based, and they all, as you can here, have like cheering sounds, fast-paced movements. It's all related to the Olympics, but we wanted to mix some of them up a bit. The only one that we changed quite a lot was our Enjoy the Moments one. I don't know if you saw that.
I think I did. I really liked that. It was really touching. It was actually really touching. For me, being an ex-sports person, it was it gave me something. It was just the music that was so different from the other adverts.
It was very emotional. We tried to make them so simple that it just reached out to our consumers and any Olympians and their families, really. We thought that it would be good to change it up a bit and get the more emotional side.
You used this animation of like sports person like performing with like the Cadbury's colours that was so effective. I was actually really impressed. I have to say. So, what do you think was the advert that has the maximum views between this? Because I've got the data for you.
Well, my personal favourite was Enjoy the Moments, but I do believe that our Race the Season one was the one that peaked the most.
It was, in fact, with 43,000 over 43,000 views. And can you guess which one was the one that was seen the less on YouTube?
No, I can't actually.
Well, I can tell you that it's the final countdown advert with over 11,000 views.
That's very interesting, as that one was very popular on our TV. We placed it a lot in the advert.
I could see. Well, this is very interesting. And what do you think is what was your target audience for all these adverts?
So, Cadbury's as general as a brand, it just has a very broad target, a very wide, sorry, target audience. Everybody loves Cadbury's, you can't deny it.
Of course.
And but for the Olympics, we wanted to sort of get the same target audience as the Olympics, and that would be, believe it or not, females that age between 29 and 39. I mean, of course males watch the Olympics too, but we wanted to focus on that age
group. Of course.
And we feel that age group could relate more to the Olympics and watch it more. Therefore, that's why we use that. We wanted to take people back to the times where the games only stopped when your mum called you for tea, for example.
Yeah.
And everyone loves tea.
Well, I noticed something actually that relates to this, which is the fact that you did the choice of music. There was also like hit songs from the 80s, such as Final Countdown, or another one which is Simply the Best, which is another one of the adverts that you use. So is this because of this like kind of like throwback feeling that you wanted to like give to the
100%, and I'm glad that you noticed that, because it's a big aspect for us, and it's good to know that some people actually notice that. It doesn't change the fact that we still were focusing on our main target audience, but we also wanted to combine the Olympics target audience.
Well, but I think that like the two target audience can be combined because they're quite much, so you actually did a very good job.
I also feel like the music we use appeals to younger generations too, because they're hit songs that they hear their parents playing and vice versa.
Of course. I agree. Well, that was great. It was great to have you here.
It was lovely discussing it.
Thank you very much. So we're here with Katie that has a fantastic guest for us.
My great friend, you probably know him from the UK Gorilla advert, which was a huge success. It's a creative director from Fallon, Aaron.
Hi Aaron, welcome. So, can you tell us about the involvement of Fallon with Cadbury's?
Well, at Fallon we led Cadbury, the Cadbury's fish advert campaign. That was a huge success for the brand. We were managed with other agencies alongside initials who led the overall campaign. They're a planning and brand activation agency, so they basically worked with us and we're alongside other partners.
Okay, so who were these partners?
So basically we had initials running the whole campaign, where then us slightly lower below it, and then working in collaboration with us as well was Pretty Green, John PhD and Brave.
Okay.
We actually have the fish ad to show you now.
Oh, that's great. Fantastic advert. Can you tell us about the main ad that we just saw, the Cadbury Fish campaign?
Well, as mentioned previously, it was part of the Spots vs. Stripes campaign, and as I mentioned, it was led by initials and us. We at Fallon came up with the whole like overall idea for this particular ad, alongside with all the other agencies having their own input. The advert was quite a success for the whole campaign, probably one of the most popular ones. It was uploaded to YouTube and it's been viewed 297,000 times.
Oh wow.
And I mean, that's a fairly good outreach considering the popularity of YouTube when it was uploaded.
Yeah, of course.
And considering the average viewing figures in that period as well, so.
It's been truly amazing, really, and it's been such a pleasure to work with him once again.
I know that you're like acquaintances, like you already know each other.
Well, yes. Well, we had so much fun doing the Gorilla advert, and we did so well that we couldn't resist asking him again.
It's a match made in heaven.
It is.
So it was surely a lovely time with our guests, and now we're gonna go back to Caroline, my colleague, that is gonna explain well how this campaign was actually striking. So here's to you, Carola.
Now I want to talk about the actual campaign and what was it all about. So basically, what Cadbury did, they sponsored the London 2012 Olympics, which was the biggest ever sponsorship, which was £15 million pounds campaign, with multiple other promotions and campaigns as well. It took 2 years of complex careful planning. It was an integrated multimedia campaign. The role of the communication within the campaign was to bring Irish people closer to the Games and by association, bring them closer to Cadbury, of course. An important role of the company of the company's 2.5 year sponsorship for the 2012 Olympic Games was occupied by the on-pack sales promotions called Unwrap the Goal, which ended up being the major. Firstly, the main objective was to get people excited about the chance to win a London 2012 Olympic package by simply buying the promotional pack. On the other hand, it was also important for Cadbury to publicly announce the winners, therefore driving purchase in order to maintain consumer involvement.
the biggest sales volume, and this obviously this campaign generated the biggest sales volume in 2 years. As Cadbury was the official tree for the 2012 Olympics, Cadbury helped grow volume sales of confectionery assortments in general by 45% year over year over the three weeks to 18 August 2012, which is quite a lot. The success of this is not only attributed to Cadbury promotion strategy, but also due to the fact that it was the only brand that specifically targeted the Olympics with its marketing. Over the same time period, total sugar confectionery volume sales fell among major multiples by minus 3%, which helped Cadbury steal market share from other sweet manufacturers. Although Olympic chief Paul Dayton was obligated to defend the sponsorship for an event associated with the battle against childhood obesity, this was quite striking, as the company chose to fight against criticism and take a risk with a 20 million plus sponsorship, as they became the official treat for the 2012 London Olympics. Cadbury planned well in advance to promote its tier 2 sponsorship for the Olympics, for which they had exclusive rights to supply all confectionery and packaged ice cream sold at the Olympic Park and at other Olympic and Paralympic venues. Because chocolate is frequently seen as unhealthy by some people, there were several debates whether or not this may be appropriate to be present at the Olympics. Despite this, it is worth noting that the Cadbury website does say that all the products have clear nutritional information that help consumers make informed choices, and the slogan "Be Treat-Wise" was presented on the front of the packs. Additionally, to actually prove that Cadbury is not trying to fatten up the nation, the brand is a member of Business for Life, which worked with the UK government Change for Life campaign. Cadbury Marketing Director Phil Rumhall said the campaign's aim was to embrace the ethos of the Olympics in all of us. Okay, so after all of this, I think it's fair that we talk about some of the recommendations that we can make for Cadbury. So in my opinion, as I talked before, they haven't quite advertised really well the fact that they are a part of the Change for Life campaign. And I think they should have advertised better the slogan "Be Treat-Wise," as people, you know, there was a lot of criticism around why Cadbury is sponsoring the Olympics. Like, that's not good for kids, that's not promoting a healthy lifestyle. So I think they could have done that much better. But I'm gonna call in my colleague now, Anna, to talk about my recommendations and see what she says.
I finally made my way back to the studio. Such a hopeful weather outside. Thank you very much, Cadbury. So we have another two recommendations. The first of all is the fact that Cadbury should have maybe taken the example of P&G as well, which made an advert that has 1 million views, which was it had like a very emotional appeal, while Cadbury did basically just humoristic advert except for one. So maybe they should have mixed up a bit more and do both an emotional appeal and humoristic appeal to just like reach the core of the consumers. And the last recommendation is the fact that some of the adverts, such as for example the Spot vs Stripes one with the fishes, that Fallon guy showed us before, they don't have much brand recognition. That it should have been like more clear, like what was the company that was advertising. Not even like the colors of Cadbury's were present, or if they were, it was just like a small fragment, while the brand should have been like recognized more in the advert. So these are our two recommendations for Cadbury.
That's great, Anna. Thank you.
Thank you for watching, and we wish you a good night.